Committee meeting to order. It's at 3:11. Roll call. Councillor Tabor.
Present.
Councillor McEachran.
Here.
Councillor Trace.
Present.
All right, so we have everybody. So everyone got some minutes and by email, I'll accept a motion. I think there were some changes, John, that you made.
Yeah, it sounds like those were made. I would move we accept the minutes as altered.
Okay.
Second.
All right, roll call vote. Councillor Tabor.
Yes.
Councillor McEachran.
Yes.
Councillor Trace.
Yes.
Okay, so we got the minutes out of the way. We're going to discuss the survey. We've got a special guest, Tracy Kearns, from the UNH Survey Center. I see we have Sam Cook. Sam, do you want to make a public comment at all?
Oh, yeah, I have a question to pose to the subcommittee.
We're not really going to take any questions. If you want to make a comment or...
I'll change it to a comment then.
Okay, that'd be great.
I also want to let folks know that we only have Tracy until 3:30. So with all due respect, can we take Tracy out of turn and then switch to Sam? Thank you.
Yeah, that's great. All right, Tracy, you're on.
All right. So the Survey Center was asked to help with analyzing the data from a recent survey that you have conducted of Portsmouth residents. It was a three-question survey. The first question asked folks to rank in order five different possible outcomes, the importance of those for the McIntyre project. The question was confusing to some of the respondents, but we did a little bit of analysis and found that 66% of the surveys that were returned and provided to us to analyze were ranked fully and correctly, meaning they gave each option a unique number between 1 and 5. 22%, I don't have my tabulation up in front of me anymore, but 22% ranked some of that. So they might have given a 1 and a 2 and left the other ones blank. And then 11% didn't rank any of them or didn't rank them in a meaningful way that we could discern what their option was. So for the most part, I would say 66% that did them correctly gives me confidence that these results, you can use them to say something about what the folks are interested in. And what we provided here, can I share my screen?
Yeah, why don't you go ahead and share your screen? That'd be great.
Okay. Sorry, I was speaking as if you could see what I was seeing. So here what we've done is because some people didn't rank all five, but they did give us a rank of a 1 and a 2 at least, we ran the analysis for the top two options. If you notice, the darker color is going to be that option was ranked as first, as most important to them. And the lighter color is something that was ranked second. So if we look at just the top rankings, 38% of respondents said that a larger, meaningful public open space, either indoor, outdoor, or a combination in one piece between the federal building and Bow Street was the most important change they'd like to see on the project. With 35% saying that the post office returning to its original location was the most important option. So those are pretty close. And then when we add the second ranks, 64%, when you add them together, first and second, gave the larger meaningful public open space as a first or second choice or importance. And 54% said returning the post office to its original location. The other three options got considerably less, especially on the first choice. Only 8% said less density and mass on Bow Street side was the most important change they'd like to see. 8% said availability of public parking, and 11% said minor changes to the existing project. When you take which ones added a second choice, 38% brings it up for the less density, 26% total for the availability of public park, and 17% for minor changes. So overall, when I look at these, I see that the two most important issues to the folks who responded to the survey is that the changes are larger, meaningful, larger and include meaningful public open space and returning the post office to its original location. Is there any questions on this set of results? No? The next two questions asked about financial commitment and the type of architecture. So the first one was changes to the project require a financial commitment from the city to achieve. Would you still support them knowing this? 75% of those who gave a response said yes, where 25% said no. And would they prefer contemporary or traditional architecture for the new building? 83% of those who answered said traditional, 16% contemporary, and 1% both. It's my understanding that there's a couple hundred surveys left to tabulate based on the number of surveys that we have already included in this and the few that are left to go. I would not expect the substantive meaning or interpretation of this data to change, but once we have that information, we would update this.
Comments, questions from anybody?
Tracy, this is just the 66% that ranked fully, is that correct?
This would be the 66% that ranked fully, as well as the 22% that ranked some. So okay. Because they didn't rank all of them, we do have enough that ranked one and two to be able to include a top two analysis.
Yeah, no, that answers my question, because obviously people who picked a top two had some strong sentiment about those two. So I'm glad right. Those were included.
There are open-ended response comments that we have not yet analyzed that I would suggest once they're put together in a format to be easily consumed, that everybody would read those. They will add context, obviously, to the data.
Tracy, this is Deglin. Thank you for this. Heard from some that they found the first question confusing. How many people ranked, instead of one being their priority, ranked from five to four? Meaning how many only ranked like a five or four or three, or went the opposite way from how we intended the survey to be written or
well,
answered?
If they ranked all five, there would be no way for us to know if they ranked it in the wrong order, right? Because they would have given us a number of one to five in each of those options.
How many ranked from impartially from five?
What do you mean?
So you the data suggests that some had ranked from one to two and left off an impartial amount from three to four to five.
Mm-hmm.
How many ranked the opposite way?
Meaning they ranked three of them but left two blank?
No, meaning starting from, I guess, as I understand, there was a number of surveys that had...
Oh, that put like just one, a five but nothing else?
Correct, yeah.
Those would be ones that we classified as not being usable.
Okay.
And Tracy, if I could, Mr. Chairman, 88% of 38,700. So we're looking at 3,260 or so as a response.
Yeah, I'm trying to open up the data set right now so I can get you an exact number, but
3687.
3,687 was our raw total, and then we've taken out the 11% that skipped question one or didn't do it in any meaningful way. But that's still a really high level of engagement for a city that has, typical municipal election of around 3,400 voters.
So I don't know anything about the distribution and how many were sent out, so I wouldn't be able to give you a response rate to this.
Tracy, it was roughly 16,500.
Okay. I can't do math in my head, but that sounds about right for a town survey these days. Response rates are incredibly hard to come by.
That's 20%, and 10% is considered good.
Yeah, absolutely. You're over 20%. I would say these are solid, solid numbers and represent your community sentiments.
Yeah, the other thing, Tracy, if you want to talk about the comments, we're capturing all the comments. So I believe on question one, we had 592 comments, correct?
Correct.
And then on question two, we had 393 comments. And question three, 492, I believe.
Right. And what we'll do is we'll clean up those comments and we'll organize them alphabetically, and you'll be able to interact with those as, look at which ones are for question one and make them searchable. You could search for the term post office to see any comments that were made about the post office or any other keyword that you might think somebody would mention. But even without the search function, I would recommend that everyone who needs to make decisions based off the results of the survey should read through the comments. We're gonna put together a brief report on this, and we'll pull out some illustrative comments to highlight the quantitative data that we're laying out. But we would still strongly recommend that you read through every verbatim comment. They will give you context and in a sense of the feelings coming from the emotion behind the quantitative data.
Did you see any preliminary themes emerging from the comments?
I have not read through every single one of them. My colleague Sean built the charts, but again, we weren't tasked at the start from doing the comments, so we didn't actually spend very much time on them. There are some of the comments I've seen just glancing through them are about being confused about the survey questions or the options that they were given, or the financial one, there's a lot of it depends. So because there wasn't specific detail other than just a financial commitment. So those comments will give you flavor.
Yeah, so the plan, John, is to kind of catch all those comments by the end of next week and put them all together in a kind of an Excel spreadsheet deck that'll go together with all the survey results. So right. everyone will be able to read through them pretty much.
Yeah, I'm really glad we went to the Survey Center to really crunch this down into some concise information. It's great.
We're happy to help.
So with that, I know we should let Tracy go, but the staff and I will work with Tracy and Sean to build on what we initially asked them to do and do the rest of the work, which would incorporate the comments. So Tracy, thanks in advance for expanding the scope with us.
Not a problem. Are there any other questions before I go?
I can't see anybody's hands, so.
You're all.
Okay. I think we're all set.
All right. Well, thank you very much. If you have any other questions, you can, Karen, forward them to me by email.
Thanks, Tracy.
Thank you, Tracy.
Take care. All right, bye.
Tracy.
So the plan is to have all the comments and everything all put together by next week, and that'll all be part of a deck, you know, that everyone can read through. I think that may be helpful, you know, moving forward for everyone to look at that. Sam, do you want to come on and make your comments or questions?
Sure. Thanks for allowing the public to join this.
I just need where you live in Portsmouth. Yes,
Sam Cook, 86 Coakley Road.
Thanks. Thank you.
So last week, or the last subcommittee meeting that I watched, you had mentioned that you would be making the results of the survey public. And so I was hoping that that also meant that you would be making the raw data along with those results public so that people could see what the totality of the survey results were. So that, you know, things like Deglin mentioned about people that might have put 5 and 4 and not 1, 2, and 3 versus like how much did that happen versus people putting just 1 and 2 to get an idea for how often the ranks were inversed. And then I also wanted to ask, so if you're not, you know, I don't know if you're not taking questions, that's fine, but I'll still put it out there about whether you're going to pay for a qualitative analysis of the comments to go along with the quantitative analysis. So that's why I joined today.
Yeah, I think the city manager and I spoke about this. I mean, we're gonna probably put this together as best we can, and the Survey Center is gonna do it all. So, and the public, if you wanna look at the raw data, I mean, actually the raw surveys, those are gonna be available for people to go through. So we just wanna be as transparent as we can, you know, through the whole process. But I think the comments will probably, you know, the 592 comments for question one will probably tell us a lot, if you know what I mean, you know, moving forward. And I haven't read them all or even looked at them yet. So I know they've got them all entered into an Excel spreadsheet so they can be sorted in any different way that we want moving forward.
All right. Thanks for your answer, and thanks for reaching out to the community. And just as a one last thing, so I have a PhD in stats. I'm a statistician, and so the 20% return that you all got, you know, they're not all usable, but that is considered a very good return. And a lot of times people will say, just like, oh, but what about the other 80%? But just from a stats standpoint, that's considered a strong public response.
Yeah, we took, we kind of drew straws on how many surveys were going to come back, and none of us were right. So for what it's worth.
We all undershot
by a lot.
All right. Well, thank you again for allowing the public to join these meetings.
All right. Thank you, Sam. So, I don't know, any comments, Ralph or Michael or?
Yeah, you know? At the risk of playing Monday morning quarterback, it would have been great to start the whole process this way, but there we are.
Right. No, I agree.
But you played a good game on Sunday, Mike. Good job.
Thanks. Unlike our friend from Tampa.
Yeah. Right. So we got the results in, you know, we'll get more, you know, on the questions next week. And, you know, on top of this, I received your letter. And I think at this point, you know, we probably, we haven't discussed that as a committee, all of us. And I think we need to do that, you know, moving forward. And then probably schedule another meeting next week. To make sure that we keep things, you know, moving in the right direction here. I don't know, is that okay with you, Michael? Are you okay with
yeah,
that?
Yeah, I'd like not to wait a full week between meetings. It's sort of,
okay.
You know, we're sort of, this has been since 2017 for us. So, you know, it sort of feels like we should move forward here.
Yeah. Do you want to meet, go ahead, Ralph. I'm sorry.
No, I'm just saying, I mean, this seems to bring tremendous clarity to the direction going forward. And you all have expressed a desire to move with a little bit of pace so we can actually get a project going. And it's very important that we start something next year. We don't, you know, we really, so, you know, I think the clarity, how do we put meat in the bones and start to move and not, you know, not keep talking about it, I guess. Pete, you know, I say that with all due respect, because it does seem to be a time to do that.
Yeah, I agree with you. So maybe we meet earlier next week. Does that work for you guys?
We're available.
I'm also, I'm happy to put, you know, more than one meeting on the calendar for next week. I'm happy to meet Monday. You know, I'm happy to increase the pace of the meetings. You know, sometimes there's stuff that we find at these meetings that we end up needing to go and produce a work product, so we don't have them at the meeting. So even if they're shorter meetings, but we have more of them, we might be able to move faster, especially because on our end, we have to notify the public of the meetings. You know, we can't make a meeting tomorrow, so that's not enough time. But if we made one for Monday, Wednesday, Friday of next week, even if they were shorter meetings or longer meetings, but we could have capped them at 15 to 30 minutes, I'm happy to do that.
What's the rest of the committee think? Go ahead, Paige.
I'm looking at my calendar at the moment, and really at this point, I'm looking at Thursday. I mean, to make it any sooner, possibly Tuesday, but then that would be going right straight from this into City Council. I mean, I'm not, you know, it's just another long day.
All right. Ralph, what's your schedule like, and Michael?
Well, I think between the two of us, we could make most things work. You know, I guess with the survey being out and being so clear, feels that we should now be able to just kind of get going, get back into an, you know, official process. So, you know.
So I'm just going to make a suggestion. Why don't we let Bob Sullivan and Justin kind of set up a schedule that's agreeable with everybody, and maybe we do it out over the next couple weeks. You know, do it out over 2 or 3 weeks if that works for everybody.
Peter,
go ahead, Paige.
Next week, I'm more like Mr. Cox. I'm more than happy to just grin and bear it, and it's important enough that no matter what happens, I'm happy to do that, because I know that for the first 2.5 weeks of October, I'm basically underwater. So I'd rather see us get as much done where I can participate.
Okay.
Might it make sense to finish our meeting today with just our subcommittee reviewing Justin's letter? Then we could hit the ground running next week and have a productive meeting maybe Monday or Tuesday.
Yeah, that was my thought too, John. I mean, I think we need to discuss that. I mean, to be honest, Ralph and Michael, we haven't, between all of us, hadn't talked about Justin's letter. I mean, yep. We all got it, but, you know.
No, that's great. Mike and I will jump off. I mean,
yeah.
We appreciate if you'll do that. That would be fantastic. We would appreciate it very much.
No, I think that works best for us. And then, you know, next week, hopefully we can hit the ground running with some solid stuff, you know, moving forward. So.
Excellent.
Does that sound like a plan for you, Justin? Is that okay?
Yeah, I think that's good. And I'll look forward to being in touch with Bob, as we talked about in our letter. Part of our concern is just making sure we have the context and the protocol down for the manner in which these discussions will take place. So I know that's what you'll be talking to Bob about, but certainly I'll be in touch with Bob and we can do it from there.
Okay.
Peter, just for your scheduling purposes, I'm available Monday through Friday, 7 a.m. to 7 p.m.
Okay.
Thanks for clarifying.
Yeah. We're bumping into our meeting calendar. But
after next week my schedule kind of frees up a little bit, hopefully. So anyway, I'm available. Go ahead, John.
Yeah, I just wanted to say that when we started the survey process way back in January, February, Ralph and Michael had said, just clarify what you want. And we thought we should go to the public for that. And I'm glad we did. I think it does give us clarity. I think the time that you've spent looking at the option with more open public space was not time wasted. You know, if that's the analysis you've been doing. So maybe we can just
Sorry, I thought you were through, Joe.
Maybe we can just get on that glide path data we have.
Yeah, that, by the way, that analysis was only meant to give you sort of a zip code of where we think it'll land. It is not much more meaning to it than that, for what it's worth.
Okay. All right, so we're going to, Beglund, if you want to make your motion.
So we're moving to, enter non-public?
Correct.
And to discuss the legal letter? All right, well, I move to enter non-public to discuss a legal pertaining letter from our development partners.
Okay. Do I have a second? Ralph?
I'll second.
All right. I have to do a roll call vote. John Tabor? Councillor Tabor?
Yes.
Councillor Trace?
Yes.
Councillor McEachran?
Yes.
And the chair votes aye. All right. So we're now going to go into a non-public.